Hi everyone. We are going to see now how the routing protocol for low-power and lossy networks called RPL said Ripple works. Let's assume you have a wireless network where some of the nodes do not have direct communication. For example, in this network where you have 8 nodes from A to I, and where a line between the nodes represents a possible radio communication. In such topology, nodes A and I cannot communicate directly. Thus, they will require relay nodes in the network to forward the packets sent from the source node I to the destination node A. In our example here, nodes H, F, C, and B may act as relay nodes. Thus, node H will receive the packet from node I and it will forward it to the node F, then to node C, then to node B, and finally node B will forward to the final destination node A. This operation is called routing. Ripple is one of the most adopted routing protocols and it is the de facto routing protocol for industrial scenarios such as the smart grid. It allows nodes to discover each other and build the paths in the network. Ripple is defined as link layer agnostic, so it can operate over wireless or over power line communication, PLC networks, for example. Moreover, it is a proactive routing protocol, which means that the routes are built independently of the data traffic. Ripple is a decentralized routing protocol, in the sense that all nodes participate in the common knowledge of the network in a peer-to-peer fashion. The network topology is organized into a special case of a directed acyclic graph, DAG, called destination-oriented DAG, DODAG, a graph where the connections between the nodes have a direction and non-circular property. Moreover, there is a single node considered to be the root, which serves as the gateway to other non-Ripple networks. You can see an example of a DODAG here. As we can see, each node will select a neighbor as a preferred parent, which is going to be its next hop towards the root. So when node I has a packet to transmit to the root, it will send the packet to node H. In order to organize the network in a DODAG, each node will compute its distance to the root in a distributed manner. This distance is called rank. The further the nodes are from the root, the higher is the rank value. For example, node B has a smaller rank than the node H. A node will compute its rank based on its neighbor's rank, and in particular, the one of its preferred parent. This information is sent in periodic packets that are called DIO. Let's take an example to see how it works. At bootstrapping, the nodes do not know their rank, except the root node. Thus, the root of the network, node A in our example, will start transmitting periodically the DIO control packets with a given rank. Typically, this rank is set to 256. Any other node has to wait to receive a DIO control packet, or they may send a DIS control packet to actually request from their neighbors to send a DIO. Then, the nodes in the propagation range of the root, in this case node B only, will receive this control packet and it will compute its own rank. There are several methods for a node to compute its rank. For instance, it can be based on the distance between the transmitter and the root node, in terms of the number of hops, or it can be based on the quality of the radio links. Either way, node B will compute its new rank, which needs to be strictly greater than the received rank. And then node B will start periodically transmitting DIO control packets indicating its own rank. Nodes C, D, and E will receive this DIO control packet sent by the node B, and they will perform the same operation as node B. More specifically, they will compute their own rank based on the rank of the node B. And then they will start sending periodically DIO control packets as well. This process will continue throughout the lifetime of the network. For the reverse route, from the root to any non-root nodes, there are two main methods called storing and non-storing modes. And the usage of another control packet, the DAO. Without entering too much into the details, the principle is that when a node selects a preferred parent, it will send a DAO to its parent toward the root to advertise its position in the topology. This position will be stored only in the root non-storing mode or in intermediate node storing mode. Note that there's a case that we did not talk about yet. What a node will do if it receives a new DIO while it already has a preferred parent, and thus a rank. Let's assume that the nodes C, D, E have chosen the node B as a preferred parent, and that they have computed their rank based on the rank of node B. When the node D receives the DIO from the node C, it needs to choose which will be its preferred parent, either to stay with the node B or to switch to node C. In order to make the proper decision, the node D will compute the rank that it will obtain through the node C. And if this rank is smaller than its own rank, then it will switch to node C. Otherwise, if the new computed rank is greater than its current rank through node B, it will keep the node B as its preferred parent. We just saw the basics of the routing protocol called RPL, Ripple. We saw how this protocol allows nodes in a network to discover themselves and determine their position in the topology in regards with the root of a DODAC. Based on the use of periodic messages, Ripple allows neighbor discovery as well as network topology maintenance. Stay tuned for more and keep safe.